Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? How about a freaking awesome set of moon phases? Oh yes, that's right. We go from waxing crescent to waxing gibbous phase in 7 days, and it will be epic. But first, let me draw your attention to the southeastern edge of the moon here. See this? That is Mare Australe, and it's a not often observed darker lava-flooded region of the moon that libration tilts into view this week. On Monday, it's fairly well placed, but the moon twists just a bit more by Sunday, giving us a prime view of this sometimes hidden area. Mare Australe is over 600 kilometers in diameter, and even though we get an oblique view of it, its large size makes it easily visible in small telescopes. Check out this overlooked Mare this week. And as if that weren't enough, check out what appears to be a letter S, formed by Mons Penck and the crater Kant, just west of the large craters Theophilus and Cyrillus. Kant, named after the German philosopher Immanuel Kant, is 32 kilometers across and over 3 kilometers deep. The diameter's not large, so use plenty of magnification. The next evening, Kant may display its central peak, but watch this crater for several nights. You can get a sense of how deep it is relative to its diameter because it continues to have a shadow along the eastern wall for several evenings. Just to the south of this area is Rupes Altai, nicely highlighted by the sun and shadow for a couple nights early in the week. These are an escarpment, or steep cliff, that extends some 400 plus kilometers, and is the largest one on the moon. It runs from just west of Catharina towards the southeast, terminating near Piccolomini, which has a nice central peak in it. But what I find more fascinating is the unnamed wavy feature formed by the tops of the craters Zagut, Lindenau, Rabbi Levi, and Retius. Try observing these features early this week. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact is to let you know that there will be changes coming to Eyes on the Sky. Don't worry, Eyes on the Sky will continue to exist, but in the next few months there will be a lot of things that will be different going forward. Please continue to be a viewer and supporter, as these changes will require some of your help too. On Wednesday, be sure to look in the southern section of the moon along the terminator. Look at how the giant walled plain of Deslandres is lit up, seemingly stretching out into the dark side of the moon. This is the second largest crater visible on the near side, and perhaps better seen as the largest one, Bailey, is along the southwestern edge. Note the small 33 kilometers across crater Hell, named after Maximilian Hell, founder of the Vienna Observatory. A bit more interesting, though, is the incomplete crater Lexell within Deslandres. This is another interesting area to watch for several nights. On the next evening, Thursday, check out the normally bright during full moon crater of Tycho, now looking much different with a deep eastern shadow. Just to the south of here, Clavius, with its complex walls and numerous smaller craters, is a favorite target of many lunar observers. And for those of you who are unable to observe until the weekend due to clouds or work or both, no worries. Copernicus is waiting to be revealed on the western side of the moon, with Reinhold and Landsberg to the south. Montes Carpatus form the lovely and complicated mountain range to its north. But while you're in that area, be sure to spend some time on the diminutive mountain range of Montes Rifaeus. But Saturday offers up one of my favorite craters, one that I know is also a favorite of my lunar observing friend Polly too, the crater Gassendi. Look at how it has inserted itself into the northern part of Mare Humorum. And that Mare shows off its western edge, much like Deslandres did, with portions of Rupes Libig and Rimae Mersenius catching bits of sunlight out beyond what most of Oceanus Procellarum displays along a large chunk of the terminator this night. And don't forget to look for Mare Australe all week! Like these kinds of videos? Subscribe, follow, like Eyes on the Sky on social media, but more importantly, consider sharing this video with others so we can educate about interesting things in the night sky and make others aware of light pollution issues. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.